Good morning. Today we're going to be looking at the centigram balance. The centigram balance is similar to the triple beam balance, but instead of three beams, this one has four beams. If the beam is not correctly zeroed, you can use the zeroing knob, the adjustment, on the far left-hand side of the beam to adjust it. There are four riders on the centigram balance. Each one represents a different mass. The largest one in the back is 100 grams. The next one is 10 grams. This small one is 1 gram. And the front small rider represents a tenth and can also be accurate to the 100th of a gram. Here's how you would take the mass of an object placed in the tray. With the beam zeroed, you first start with the largest rider, which would be the 100 gram rider. We'll move it once. The arm doesn't go down, so we move it again. Okay, now we've gone too far, so we're going to go back one. Okay, now we use the 10 gram rider. So I'll move it once. Doesn't go down all the way, so let's get a 20, and it goes down. So we'll go back to 10. Make sure the riders are locked into place in these notches. So now let's use the 1 gram rider. So we'll move it over one, and the arm stays down, so that's too far. We'll go back to zero. Arm comes up. Now we'll use the front rider, and we want to zero this mass, and when the lines here are even, we have the proper mass. So I need to go a little bit farther. And it looks like a little farther. And you keep doing that until the mass is properly shown on the scale. To read this now, we would just add up the parts. This one is on the 100. This one is on 10. This one is on 0. So we have 110. And then you add the front. It is past the 0.1, not quite up to the 0.2. So it's 0.1, and then we count the smallest lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, so this is 0.19. So the total mass for this block is 110.19 grams. Okay, let's take the mass of something that's a little smaller this time. Here's a rubber stopper. We'll put it on the scale. We'll start with the largest rider. 100's too much, so we'll go back and then try the 10 gram rider. Keep going until the arm falls. Okay, there we go, 30's too much, so we'll go back to 20. Now we'll use the 1 gram rider. You must start with all the riders pushed all the way to the left, with it zeroed. Okay, 24, 25's not enough. We're getting closer. Let's try 28. Okay, the rider stays, the arm stays down at 28, so we go back to 27. Now we use the front rider. Go over about halfway, still not enough. A little farther. Okay, and the arm starts to fall. I think we've gone a little too far, so let's go back. And we settle on 27.69. This front rider is very close to, but not past, 0.70. So we say it's 0.6, look at the little lines, 9. To measure the mass of a chemical in the lab, we can't just put chemicals directly onto the scale, onto the metal tray, because there could be a reaction. We'll use a plastic weighing tray that will not react and put it on the scale, and we'll use what's called the TARE method, T-A-R-E. TARE method means that we're going to first get the mass of the weighing tray. Then we'll get the mass of the chemical plus the weighing tray and just subtract out the mass of the tray. So let's first get the mass of the tray. The mass of the tray is 2.22 grams. Now that we know the mass of the tray, we can add our chemical. And for this demonstration, I'm just going to add some salt. pour the salt into the weighing tray, and now we'll find the new mass. So I'm going to start over. Start at 100. Too much. 10, 20, 30, 40. There we go. So let's go back to 30. Remove the 1 gram rider until it goes down. 4 is not enough. 6 is not enough. 8 is not enough. 9 is not enough. 10 is too much, so we'll go back to 9. And now we'll use the small rider. The mass of the salt and the weighing tray is 39.22 grams. So in order to get the mass of the salt now, we're going to subtract 2.22 grams for the tray from the 39.22 grams, and that would mean that the mass of the salt is exactly 37.00 grams.